So in my last video, I said this. I'm not talking about GTA 4's performance. That has and likely always will be an issue.
That has and likely always will be an issue.
Thankfully, several of you commented on that video correcting me, telling me about DXVK, a project which adds a Vulkan-based translation layer to DirectX 9, 10, and 11 games. GTA 4 is a DirectX 9 game, so it works with that. At first, I was skeptical. Most of the time, I find performance fixes generally don't work and they're a waste of time. I was very, very wrong. My PC is nothing special. In fact, it's pretty outdated at this stage and struggles to run games made after 2019. I typically get a lot of stutters in newer games due to my CPU, and my GTX 1070 isn't good enough to play at higher settings like it was years ago. GTA 4 was no exception. It ran, but stutters were very frequent no matter what I did, so I put it down to my PC simply not being enough for this dreadful 15-year-old port. Anyway, you guys told me about DXVK, and I decided to give it a try. Let's take a look at the performance with and without it so you can see just how much it improves GTA 4. All tests here were done with max settings at 1440p on the latest Steam version of GTA 4. So the first test will involve standing still in the middle of Star Junction with an unlocked frame rate. In the vanilla game, the performance is hovering around 50 frames per second. We're not moving or doing anything and there's no action going on. This is just Liberty City ambience. With DXVK, our performance is dramatically increased. We go from 50 frames per second to 80 frames per second, which slowly decreases as more vehicles appear on screen. We start to hover around 67 to 70 frames per second. Now the next test with an unlocked frame rate will be flying across the map. This isn't a normal scenario you'll find yourself in during normal gameplay, but the difference in performance is still quite large. In the vanilla game, we jump from the 60 FPS range to around 80 while flying through the city. However, we are getting a lot of stutters while doing so. Every time the frame time graph has massive jumps like this, the game is stuttering heavily. But with DXVK, not only is our average frame rate much higher, almost always being over 100 frames per second, the stutters aren't nearly as bad as they were in the vanilla game. However, in my opinion, you shouldn't be playing with an unlocked frame rate, not unless you're getting over 100 frames per second constantly and you have a display which supports variable refresh rates. Ideally, when playing a game like this, you want to lock your frame rate. If you don't, the constant changes in frame rate will make the game feel like it's stuttering, as the frame time can change dramatically depending on the scene. For my PC, 60 FPS is the perfect frame rate to lock the game to. To lock my FPS, I'm using RivaTuner Statistics Server. This allows you to lock the frame rate of any 3D application, and in my experience, provides much more consistent frame times over in-game frame limiter solutions. So, with our game locked at 60 frames per second, we should expect a nice, smooth experience with a steady frame time, right? With the vanilla game, no, not really. If you look at the frame time graph, there's constant stuttering and our frame rate keeps dropping, making the experience feel absolutely awful. With DXVK, we get one tiny stutter as we leave the building, and then one big stutter as we start running. That's likely caused by the fact that the game has only been launched. After that, we have zero performance issues. The game is running at a consistent 60 frames per second with absolutely flawless frame times. So what about driving? As expected, the vanilla game isn't a fun experience at all. The frame rate keeps dropping and the stuttering is honestly unbearable. There's constant micro stutters as seen in the frame time graph and occasionally a big stutter. This basically never stops. DXVK is absolutely perfectly smooth, a constant 60 frames per second with perfect frame times. So, what if we fly around the heavy part of the map really quickly? As usual, the vanilla game is absolutely abysmal. The frame rate isn't steady, the stuttering is constant, and it's really not good enough for such an old game. DXVK is near perfect. There's some very, very small stutters occasionally. However, I honestly didn't even notice them aside from their presence in the frame time graph. Flying around the map this fast is also something you'll never do in actual gameplay either. So I think you get the point. DXVK provides insane performance improvements to GTA 4, and it's basically necessary to run this game on PC. Without DXVK, you'll get constant stuttering no matter what you do, even on PCs, which should be capable of running this 15-year-old game. DXVK is a necessity. So, let me show you how to install it and set it up. Installing DXVK is fairly simple, but just some quick notes. I've only installed DXVK on the complete edition of GTA 4, which is the latest version on Steam. The version of DXVK used in this video was version 2.2, which is the current latest version at the time of recording. To install DXVK, you'll need 7-zip to open the archive it comes in. I'll leave a link to 7-zip below. You don't need any other mods to get DXVK working, so if you just want to install DXVK and then play GTA 4, you can do that. However, the PC version does have more issues aside from performance, including inferior graphics when compared to the console version. I have a video covering these differences, which I'll link on the screen now. Before you do install DXVK, go into your graphics settings in GTA 4 and take note of how much video memory you have. I have 8GB with my GTX 1070. That's shown as 8000MB. Type your video memory value down somewhere, as you'll need it later. Lastly, installation methods might change in the future, so be sure to check the description or pinned comment to see if anything has been changed since I uploaded this video. Anyway, let's get to installing DXVK. Step 1. Download the latest version of DXVK from the link in the description. Step 2. Open the .gz archive with 7-zip. Once opened, open the .tar archive inside. Step 3. Open the DXVK folder inside that archive, then open the x32 folder. Step 4. Copy everything from the x32 folder into your GTA 4 folder. This is the folder where gtaiv.exe is located. Okay, before you leave this video, that's not all. DXVK is installed, but for some reason, this causes the game to think you have very little video memory. When the game thinks you haven't got enough video memory, it won't let you increase settings. So to fix this, you have to force the game to think you have more video memory. You can do this inside a file called commandline.txt. GTA 4 doesn't have one by default, so we'll create one. So step 1, inside the GTA 4 folder, create a new .txt file called commandline.txt. Step 2. Open commandline.txt with any text editor and type the following: dash available vid mem, followed by the video memory value you took down earlier. So for me, that was 8000MB. After that, go to a new line and enter dash no pre-cache. Once you have both lines like shown here, save the file. And that's it. DXVK is now installed, and GTA 4 should run a whole lot better compared to before. If you need any help, feel free to join my Discord server. Hopefully myself or someone else can help you out. Anyway, that is finally all. If you found this video helpful, be sure to give it a like. If you like GTA modding videos, don't forget to subscribe as well. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you later.